Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and I wanted to show you how to transfer from your current phone to a new iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro, or iPhone 11 Pro Max. Now this will show you how to transfer step by step from your device and bring everything along with you. Now this method will bring over everything. This is the official way to do this according to Apple. And as you can see here, I have an iPhone XR, which is the older one, and an iPhone 11. And I've already transferred information with this one. And you can see that it brings over everything, even the app layout. So not only does it bring over the app layout, but it brings over all data from your messages, from your mail. It signs in your email accounts. Occasionally you'll have to put in your password, but most of the time you will not. It carries over all the data from almost every single application, including music and everything you've saved in here. So you won't lose any information, including your photos. And there's three different ways that you can back up and restore now. And the newest method is a direct data transfer. So just make sure you're on the latest version and you can do the direct data transfer. Otherwise you'll need to use iTunes or iCloud. Now the direct transfer method is typically the fastest, especially if you have a slow internet connection. So I recommend that to most people, and I'll show you how to do that in a moment. But if you have an older phone that's older than iOS 12, for example, you'll need to either use iCloud or iTunes. So if you use iTunes, that's pretty simple. You just plug your phone into a Lightning port, then into a Mac or Windows computer, use iTunes to back up and then restore. However, there's two easier methods. One is iCloud, like I said, and make sure you have an iCloud backup first if you're going to use iCloud. So go to Settings, then tap on your name, then tap on iCloud, and here you can see how much storage you have. And right now I have 2 terabytes available because I pay for the top tier. If you have a full account where you can't back up anymore, then you can either pay for more storage for the month, use iTunes, like I said, or use the direct data transfer, which is the best. But just make sure you have a backup, and you can check for a backup here if you're going to use the iCloud method. And here it will tell you the last time it was backed up. So just make sure that it's current. So now let me show you how to directly transfer from one phone to another. So we'll go to the new phone and we'll turn it off and back on, unlock it, and immediately on the left, it should pop up and say, do you want to set up a new phone? And it should have your Apple ID in that. So go ahead and click continue. It will connect, and now you'll have to hold your phone on my left hand here, which is the older phone, and just line it up with this little ball of whatever this is, pixels here. And you'll see it says connecting. So now we'll go ahead and put in the passcode from our current phone on the new one. So this is the same passcode if Face ID doesn't work or Touch ID doesn't work. Once the passcode is in, it'll say setting up your phone. So just be patient. It can take a little bit, and then we'll go to the next step. Now it will activate your phone. And many of you are going to ask, do I need to put my SIM card in before or after? Really, nowadays, it doesn't matter. You can put it in now, you can put it in later. It doesn't matter. I'm going to put it in after everything's transferred over. And then I'm going to tell you how to delete the phone, because if you want to give away your old phone, sell it or trade it in, do not delete the phone individually as far as photos and things like that. You want to wipe it all at once or you'll lose your information because they sync. So go ahead and set up Face ID on the new phone. We'll hit get started. And then all you need to do is put your face in the camera and then move your head around. It scans your face and recognizes only you. Unless you have a twin, then that can change. Then just try it in the other direction or the same direction. It doesn't really matter. I just do it that way. It says it's set up now, so we'll hit continue. Now I would suggest transferring from iPhone. Now you can do an iCloud restore like I showed you with that backup, and that's just a precaution or a different way to do it, or other options will allow you to transfer through iTunes. But I suggest you hit transfer from phone. It says 40 to 50 minutes, but I find this to be faster than that. So we'll tap on transfer from phone. It's going to set up my Apple ID from my old phone to my new phone, and it will carry all of your Apple ID information with it, including passwords if you have those saved. Now, as you can see, it says keep this iPhone near your new phone while your information is transferred. So they talk directly to one another. It basically sets up a wireless connection between the two phones and transfers the information from the old to the new. So it can take a little bit of time. Now here we need to accept the terms and conditions. If we don't agree, we can't use it. And then also we have some other settings as well that it wants us to set up first. So if you don't want to use Siri, you don't have to. I allow it to use Siri and things like maps to use my locations. And then also I share analytics with Apple. So that means they send information anonymously if you have a crash, maybe an application doesn't work, but we'll hit continue. Then we can install updates manually or continue. I'd rather have them manually so I can check for them. I don't want them to install in the background. Now here is where we update Apple Pay. This is the one thing where we will have to re-verify our credit cards with our credit card company or bank accounts. I'll set this up later. And then if you have an Apple Watch, such as this one, and you want to move it over to the new phone, go ahead and hit continue, or you can set that up later. And then here's app analytics, and you can share this with developers, or you don't have to. I'm not going to share for now. You can do it later if you want to. It's really up to you. Either way doesn't really matter. Now you can see it says transferring data from Aaron's iPhone XS Max. And you'll see it changed over here, and it says transferring data to iPhone. So we'll just let this transfer, and it may take a while, but all of our information should move. Now what it's going to do is after it's done transferring, it will start installing the apps. So it moves all of the information from the apps, and then it downloads the apps. So I'll show you what I mean once this part's done. Now, as you can see here, it says time remaining about 2 hours. I find this varies greatly. It went to 3 hours and came back to 2 hours. It just depends what it's doing. Normally, it's about 20 to 30 minutes, depending on how much data you have on your current phone. Now, as you can see, it says transfer complete on the old phone. And then on the new phone, it has rebooted and you'll see we've got the Apple logo. So it'll take just a minute and restart. Now it has taken about 40 minutes or so to transfer everything, but I did have almost 100 gigabytes of data. And you'll see it says before you trade in or give away or sell this phone, you should completely erase it by going to settings and choosing erase all content and settings. This is like I showed you at the beginning. You do not want to go into photos and delete them individually. That will actually transfer over to the new phone if you have iCloud photos turned on. You want to wipe this phone completely and you won't lose anything on the new phone, but just make sure the new phone is all set. So let's check it out. We'll put in our passcode and now it's going to reboot here or restore our information. And again, after you've transferred everything over, just make sure that they look the same. Now, at first, your information will actually transfer as you're using it in real time. For example, if you're using iMessage and you message someone, that message will show on the new phone. So you don't want to delete them here as it will transfer over and delete it from your new phone. So just wipe this phone. So once it's wiped, you can sell it, whatever you want, turn off Find My Phone, and you're good to go. Now, once the phone has rebooted, it will have the same wallpaper as it did before. Let's go ahead and swipe up to unlock here. And there we go. Now it's asking me if I want to use this device when sharing your location. And yes, you do. Now that you have your old phone gone, you want to use this phone for your location. And you'll see all of the apps are dimmed and waiting to install. The actual information has moved over, but the apps themselves are not there. So it will take a little bit. It's going to move everything over and you'll be good to go. All the stock apps will be there and all of the same information will be here. So you'll see all of the apps are there in the same location. All of the information is transferring and it takes a little while. And this depends on your internet connection. So you can move your SIM card now, you're ready to go, and give it some time, because if you have a lot of photos and a lot of data, it's going to take a while to go from here to here with iCloud and everything, depending on how you're using that. But everything should be there. Now, if you're nervous about that, don't wipe your phone yet. Make sure everything transfers before you go ahead and erase the old phone and get rid of it or give it away or sell it or whatever you're doing. It's okay to use both at the same time. I use them at the same time all the time, and all of the information is on both. So don't worry about that. It will all be here. That's it as far as transferring all of your information. Hopefully that helped you. It's pretty simple and straightforward. Once you've learned how to do it, it's simple the next time. But all of your information should be there. I'm still installing all the apps, but all of your information will be there when it's done. But let me know what you think in the comments below. If you have any other questions, I do try and answer them if I can. And hopefully I can help if you have any of those extra questions. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.